and welcome back to Innovation Oxford. I'm here with Dan Alyea, who's going to teach us about baling, but not just any bales, like new baling.
Yep.
Yeah, and what's new about it?
There's a lot of new technology these days. It's really changed from the old days where you'd start stuking or even small square.
Oh, what? Start what?
Stuking?
Stuking?
Well, that's a very, very old traditional method of gathering grain in. Whereas today you'll see combines with 30 and 40 foot wide headers on them. Back in the old days, you'd go out with a scythe and you would just start gathering up the wheat or the oats or whatever the grain was, and you'd basically put it in a bundle and you'd leave it out till it was good and dry, and then you would take it to the barn and start thrashing it out for your grain.
Now today you were using a combine. There was a combine going on taking out. What is involved in combining basically hay or straw?
Well, we don't combine hay. We've a bit of a different system there, but as far as combining straw, you have what's called a flex header on the front of the combine.
It's gigantic when it comes up, you know, when we take a look at
it. It's about 30 feet wide, ours, and basically it's just a series of knives all grouped together, and they'll cut along, cut the weed off and feed it into the combine, and the combine is basically a self-propelled thrashing machine, whereas the old days, you'd get a group of a group of farmers together and they'd start thrashing each other's grain. Well, now it's just one combine, and it's nothing to cover 60 or 70 acres in a day.
It looked like it was real easy and could have been real hot in there, but it looked like it was getting the job done. That replaced probably, 1,000 slaves from from Egyptian times, but that's a massive machine. That's your machine?
Yeah, that is our own combine. Yep.
And you rent property or you actually do it for other farmers?
Yeah, our farm is a cash crop, which generally is referred to corn, soybeans, wheat. We do some hay, and the custom work side of the business is where we go out and physically do the work for other farmers. Combines are a brand new combine, not like ours, but a brand new combine will cost you well north of $500,000 these days. So not everybody can afford to do that. Go out and buy one. So.
I know I couldn't. But tell me what the difference is between straw and hay.
Straw is strictly, or I shouldn't say strictly, it's generally used as your bedding for your animals, chickens, your horses, cows, all generally use straw.
Now, straw is a byproduct of something else, isn't it?
Yeah, straw is a byproduct of your grains like wheat or oats, mixed grains like that.
So after you take that crop off, you're left with straw.
Yep. Essentially, the combine will come along and cut it off about 2 or 3 inches off the ground generally, and those that will harvest the straw will put it in a windrow. The combine will do that and leave it in a nice row about 4 or 5 feet wide, and then we'll come along and we'll bale it up.
So, all right, and so hay is different.
Hay is a perennial crop. So you'll plant it generally in the spring. Sometimes you'll plant some later in the fall. And after it's established, you'll come in and you'll take 3 or 4 cuts a year off that. After you cut it, you'll harvest it somehow. You'll bale it or put it in a silo. And then it'll grow back. And in a month or 6 weeks, you'll go back and you'll do it all over again. You can easily take 3 or 4 cuts a year off.
And it's got nutrition in it.
Yes, hay is a primary source of nutrition for dairy and beef cows especially, and horses.
And so why, we're completely surrounded by very fertile land here in Oxford County, but why would you want to plant hay?
Generally, most farmers any farmer that has dairy cows especially, or beef cows, they need it as feed. And they'll put probably well over half of their land into hay just to generate enough feed to keep their cows going.
So they don't, it's a crop that feeds something else. Yeah.
Yep, absolutely.
All right. And this field we're in here, is this finished?
This wheat field, I still have a lot of baling to do, I just started, but this field can either be now planted into something else. Either this fall, we may put some alfalfa in later this fall, but it is getting late enough in the year for that. Or next year we'll come in and we'll plant corn into this field.
Now, we're behind a machine here that's obviously baling, but this is one mega bale. I mean, that's about a meter, By a meter and a half?
You're pretty close there. It's that's what's referred to as a 3x3 big square baler. And this is actually the baby of big square balers. They have 3x4 balers, so 3 feet high and about 4 feet wide. And then the really, really big machines, and there aren't any around here in Oxford County that I know of, they'll actually make a 4-foot by 4-foot wide bale.
Why do you want to make them bigger?
Efficiency, basically.
So basically the labor involved, it's the same labor to take something that's small as it is to move something that's big?
Yep, and where it was a lot more common in the even 20 or 25 years ago to have small square balers on a lot of farms, a linear foot of this big square baler will do 2.5 small square bales.
Wow.
So,
and of course it's
pound for pound.
It's gathered up there inside and mm-hmm. sort of compressed into a shape and then spit out here having been wrapped.
Yeah, it wraps the twine around it. There's a series of knotters up in the top of the baler and needles in the bottom, just kind of like a sewing machine. And this machine has four on it, and when it ties the bale, it'll bring the four strings up from the bottom and the knotter will take them and wrap them into a knot, and it just continues on. You don't even know it, other than the monitor beeps to tell you that it did it. You don't even realize it.
I mean, this is necessary, isn't it? The kind of productivity gain we've made in farming. I mean, we can produce more with less overhead.
Exactly. And, you know, these machines aren't cheap either, but...
As we drive around here, and as we're wont to do in Oxford County, we're going to see different kinds of baling. And the one that always catches our eye is the one that's round, that seems to be plastic wrapped.
Yep, that is hay, and that's just another method, whereas... instead of putting it in a silo or a bunker silo, you can wrap the hay when it's wet, and it will ferment itself inside the plastic. It's like its own little mini silo. That's the purpose of a big tall silo or a bunker silo, where they cover it in cover the bunker silo in plastic. The idea of that is to get it to heat up and ferment to make feed. It's just a different type of different way of haying.
And so you leave it right in the field.
Plastic wrap bales, generally we moved off to the side somewhere, but yeah, or hauled to the back to the farm, but you can just leave them outside, and as long as the rodents don't get into them, they're good.
You know, it looks like it's going to rain today. Is it going to rain?
Well, there is a chance tonight. That's why we're hoping to get all this baled up yet today.
So you got all your work cut out for you. You were here in Oxford Center, and so I guess it proves the axiom that you got to make hay while the sun shines.
That's true.
That's true. We'll see you next time.